Hi, I'm Dr. Nicole Vane, the owner of Moonlight Beach Dental, a holistic, biologic, and integrative dental practice. And one of the things I wanted to talk today about is surgical extractions. When you need to have a tooth removed, hopefully you never will, but if you do, how does that affect my body and what's the proper way of going about it? So, since I entered into this field of holistic dentistry, I want to describe how it's different from the traditional way that we do an extraction or pull a tooth, as the layperson would say. So the way we're trained in dental school is we take out the tooth. We just make sure all of the tooth is removed from the socket. So if we remove the tooth, we remove the infection, right? Well, that's how we're trained. So 99.9% of dentists, that's all they do. Now, if you're familiar with the holistic protocols, Hal Huggins has created essentially the main school of thought on this, is that there's something around the tooth called the periodontal ligament. And that is the ligament fiber that runs all the way around the tooth in the tooth socket or in the alveolus. And he's found over time that if that's left behind, if we don't scrape and curette that out in a very specific way, that we're leaving behind infection, which then essentially slumps into the socket. And then instead of having beautiful, healthy bone refilling the socket, you get granulation tissue, which is essentially really gunky, yucky tissue that then is closed over into your jaw, and it creates problems down the road as a foci of infection called a cavitation, which is something that's in another video. But essentially, you want to make sure that whomever is removing your tooth is taking out all of this periodontal ligament and then preserving the socket in the correct way. Now, typically, the reason we preserve the socket essentially is you're going to have a big hole in there, right? Well, your body eventually is going to fill that in. So you're thinking, why does this even matter? Well, in some of our other videos, we'll talk about implants and implant options. That's the best way to replace a tooth. And if we take out the bone, or take out the tooth, we lose all the bone because the only purpose of alveolar bone, which is what jawbone is to hold the tooth in. So you take the tooth out, we don't need the bone. The socket essentially fills in from the top and the bottom, and the site shrinks down over time. And if it's on the upper arch, your sinus will pneumatize or drop into that space. So if you want an implant, even a year after an extraction, sometimes we just can't. There's no bone there. So what we're also trained in dental school or in oral surgery residency to do is to pack that socket with bone. So now we're going to take some artificial bone and we're going to fill up that socket, and that's going to serve as a matrix for all of our own bone cells to fill in. That sounds awesome, right? Sounds amazing. Here's the problem. Holistically, that's usually cadaver bone that's been sterilized, or it's cow bone. So it's a foreign body. It doesn't heal well. So even if the bone feels firm to the surgeon placing the implant, for some people, especially people that are acutely sensitive, it's also still a foci of infection. They get mushy bone that's essentially filled with a lot of bacteria mixed in because it's a foreign body reaction. Your body's saying, I don't want this in here. So how does our technique differ? So when you're trained through the Huggins protocol, they train you on how to remove the ligament. Now I want to just use a visual aid here. So essentially, this is showing a tooth already missing, but let's go ahead and cut off the gums. And what do we see? We see an extraction socket. So essentially in the socket is that periodontal ligament that outlines the imprint of where the tooth was in the jawbone. And then we're taught to fill that in with all this bone. Then we stitch the area over, our own bone fills in, then we can place an implant down the road, or we can do a nice bridge or something that looks a lot more natural because you don't have the caving in of the bone. Sounds great. So what if you need a bone graft? Well, how do we know when we need one anyway? The way that we determine that is essentially how aggressively, one, we have to remove the tooth, and two, your body's clot is a scab that actually acts as a matrix for your bone to fill in. The problem is what I described earlier, it fills in from the top and the bottom and essentially just shrinks down. You end up with this caved in area. So one of the techniques we use here is socket preservation with PRF. What's PRF? P PRF is platelet-rich fibrin. There's also PRP, platelet-rich proteins, getting a lot of good things in the whole entire medical community. And essentially, we have you go get a blood draw before your appointment at one of the labs we work with. You bring in the vial of blood here, and essentially what they do with it is they centrifuge it. So they spin down the blood, and then we get this really cool gummy bear, is what I like to call it, looking piece that floats to the top, kind of like cream on the top of whole milk. And so it floats to the top, we pull out this gummy bear clot, and we pack the entire socket in with that after we've properly removed all of the periodontal ligament. Now what that does is it acts as a matrix, just like your own blood clot would, but it's filled with all the most beneficial healing properties that your body has for healing a wound. Essentially, it's kind of like stem cells. It brings in all the best healing elements for getting that socket to heal quickly and painlessly. Since I started using this technique years ago, I found I have no post-operative complications. I've never had a case of dry socket. And also, patients heal amazingly well and the bone fills in so much better. But some people still need a bone graft. What do they do then? Well, that's for a conversation with the surgeon. Essentially, there's a lot of ways to get an autogenous graft or something that's of you. Sometimes they can ground up. There's a new technique grounding up pieces of the tooth. There's techniques for shaving some of your jaw here. They can shave if you need a bigger piece from your hip. They can take a piece of rib. Depending on what needs to be done, they have some really, really, really cool techniques. The other important thing that we use here in this practice that's unique is ozone also. Now, I have a lot of other videos on ozone. I'm really passionate about ozone. You can read about ozone and why you need a dentist who uses it on the IAOMT website. But essentially, after we've removed the tooth, we clean out the infection, and then we clean out the periodontal ligament. We take ozone and ozone gas and water that's fresh. It's at a very specific dosage. The ozone actually shoots into and collapses the fistula, which is like a little channel that creates that pimple that some people have draining onto their gums. And it does that through oxidation. It just blasts the area with oxygen. So the other advantage to using such a high dose oxygen is they discovered it in World War I for treating patients with gangrene. And essentially the oxygen, the extra oxygen, the free radical oxygen, reperfuses the area and it causes the regrowth of the capillaries that were torn with the extraction. So the coolest part is that once we start injecting it with the ozone, is the bleeding just stops. The body's like, I don't need to keep bleeding to bring these white blood cells and other clotting factors into the area. I'm good, I'm taken care of. So we take the ozone, we put that in there, that cleans out all the hidden infection that can be left in there so that your body actually stimulates healing. Then we put the PRF in there, and then I use a collagen membrane over the top of it, and then I use some resorbable natural sutures that go on top of that. And it's the best technique ever. I tell you, we have, again, patients that just heal so beautifully and without complication. So these are important conversations to have with any dentist you choose who might be extracting your tooth.